My name is Stephen Neal. I grew up here in San Diego, was raised in a Christian home. My parents decided to take myself and my brothers to the Philippines for a two-year missions trip. Went to Horizon Christian Fellowship, that was our church. Enjoyed the high school ministry. I was surrounded by a lot of great people. Was prepared to go off to college and participate in sports. And in doing so, I kind of lost that shelter of protection and all the strong Christian role models around me. I started looking for a church. I'd go to one church one week and I'd go there again and it didn't feel the same, and I'd go to a different church. I was just making a lot of excuses like, well, the worship team isn't good here. I don't like this pastor's voice here. Just making a lot of excuses that really the bottom line is I don't know if I really wanted to go to church. Then I started missing one weekend here and then two weekends, and the next thing you know, I wasn't even attending church services. Go back with my parents and go to church. And I still believed in Jesus, I still loved him, but I wasn't serving him and I wasn't living a Christian godly life. Ironic, because during those times I started having a lot of success in the athletic world. I was an All-American 4 years and I was national champion 2 years in a row, undefeated, but my Christian life wasn't really where it needed to be. I was all set to make the U.S. Olympic team in 2000 and represent the United States and Australia and go to Sydney and win the gold medal. I was the favorite. I go to the Olympic trials and I end up taking second to a guy that I beat the year before. I think that was a way for God letting me know, hey, you know, you can do so much, but I'm in charge here. You know, it was a time I could have changed, but I didn't. I was able to get an opportunity to play football for the New England Patriots of the NFL. Had met a woman in college and we'd been going together for quite a while, and so we ended up getting married. She was not a believer and it didn't bother me at the time. Like I said, I was living in the world. And my wife, who was not a believer, she kind of got me back into church. She wanted our kids to be raised in the church and with some godly principles, which kind of focused my attention back towards God, even through all these injuries. And that was a saving grace for me. You know, being a son of a missionary family and a strong Christian in high school, leaving, going away to college, meeting a girl, going away to New England, to the other side of the country, and she's the reason why I'm at church now and not my upbringing. It's definitely kind of a little bit ironic for her to be saving me when I could have been the one that saved her. Yeah. So the off seasons, we came back here to California, and my parents said, you guys are living up there in Poway, Rancho Bernardo area. There's a great church, Maranatha Chapel. And so we decided to attend, and right away we heard Ray, and it's like, man, this guy has a lot of wisdom. I would love to say I just jumped in and gave my life back to Jesus right away, but I was real protective of it for some reason. I still wanted to live a little bit in the world and not fully give myself back to Christ. My wife and I, we've been hearing about getting into a small group. We said, you know what, it's about time. So she took charge and she jumped in a group on Tuesday morning, and I decided I'm gonna try this group on Tuesday night. It was the men's discipleship group. I had a great time. All the guys in there were really, really good, and it was something. I started looking around and I said, you know what, I'm gonna do this, you know. And then you start thinking, Jesus died for me on the cross. And I decided right then, you know what, I wanna live my life making him proud. Everything else kind of just vanishes away, and you realize a lot closer to that path than I was trying to do everything on my own.